Hey everyone, on today's video, what we're going to talk about is improving web typography with CSS. So here on the screen is we have a fairly good site, but how do we actually go about improving this? So you can notice here there's a few things that we could find wrong with this. So for instance, we have these words that kind of live on their own called widows. We see our line lengths are really, really long as well. And also if we make our site responsive, then our type scale doesn't really change as well. So what we're going to do is turn the site from something like this to this, and all it takes is just a few lines of CSS, very, very quick to do. So we're going to show you three tips of how to do this very, very quickly. So let's have a look at how this site actually works right now. So in our code, what we have is just some simple HTML and CSS. We've got our H1s, our H2s, Ps. We've got a list in here as well. And in our star sheet, we've got the regular old stuff. We've got our font faces, which basically set up the correct typography in here. I'm setting up a font size in HTML just to kind of use rems in here, root ems, which basically means that we're sizing things based on this unit. And we have our kind of color schemes in here. We've got our typography and fairly kind of basic typography as well. So something that looks like this. So tip number one, what do we want to do? Well, currently these line lengths are really, really long. So here, if our user is reading this, their eyes might get tired because they're kind of like reading and kind of looking left and right. So how do we go about fixing this? Well, what we want to do is make these have a set length. So the quick way to do this is something like this. So we're going to pick the H1, the H2, and P tags in here, and we're going to give them a maximum width. Now, the kind of most obvious thing you might do here is say a pixel width, so something like 600 pixels, and we'll save, and let's see how this looks. But again, you can see here, this looks okay for things like paragraphs, but it doesn't really look okay for things like our titles. So how do we go about fixing this? Well, what we want to do is basically base this unit in a relative size. So one way to do this is use something like ems. So ems are based on the font size. We can do something like 30m, something like that. And what you'll get is something a little bit cleaner. We can see this one is a little bit wider than this one, which is a little bit wider than this one. Now, ems are basically based on the height of an m, the height of an m. But what we might want to do is basic on a width instead. Now, is there a unit we can use that's based on a width? Because obviously these are going across. Well, what we can do is use something called a ch, a kind of character unit instead. And what we want to do is base this on how wide a zero is in this font. So what we can do instead is something called 60ch, which is actually a really useful thing. This is basically 60 characters long if the character was just zero. And it looks pretty good. So if I save this now and refresh, what we'll see here is this looks a little bit cleaner. We can see our paragraphs don't look too long. And these are kind of going kind of what we want as well. We can kind of play around with this as well. So maybe something like 50 instead. Somewhere between 50 and 60 kind of works really well for this. So there we go. Now we still have the issue with these widows as well. So how do we go about doing this? Now in the past, there was a way to do this, which is kind of a bit of a hack, which is to add something called a non-breaking space to your HTML. So what we would do is the last two words, we would add a special thing with an ampersand and an NB, SP, and then a semicolon. And this is called a non-breaking space, which basically pushes this onto the next line. And this kind of does the thing we want it to do. But there is a bit of an issue, especially when we get responsive. You can see here that this doesn't look very good because this never breaks. So what do we do to fix this? Well, firstly, let's get rid of that old way of doing things. Let's do the new way instead. So this is a fairly new thing, and we're only really going to do this on the titles, the H1s and H2s. So H1 and H2, what we're going to add in here is something called text wrap balance. So here I'm going to do text hyphen wrap and balance. Now this is a quite new thing, which you can see here it is complaining because it doesn't know what it is. It's so new that my kind of plugin is kind of not working it out. So this does work in a lot of browsers, not every single browser, but it's a really good tip for basically balancing this text. Now one thing you might be wondering is why did we not just do this on the p tags as well? Well, when we're doing things on p tags as well, what we will get is our text balancing across every bit of text, and it kind of decides on its own, like paragraph, for instance. which means that sometimes you'll get some kind of paragraphs looking thinner and some looking wider. So I don't like to do this. I like to kind of keep this just on my kind of titles, anything large. So this is just a personal preference. P's can kind of look a little bit weird now and again. So we've kind of tied up our general type here. Now, what we might want to do as well is make this more responsive. Now, the quick way to do this in a responsive way would be to just add a media query. But what we can do is add something a little bit smarter than this. So currently in my HTML, I've got my font size being 28. This is kind of fixed in size. If I was to do this with a media query, I'd say HTML font size 21, let's say. But what we can do is basically make it calculate instead. So we don't want it to be just 28. What I'm going to replace this with is a CSS calculation, calc. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is say, what is the very, very smallest font size I want here? Well, something like 16, maybe 16 pixels. So if I save this now and refresh, what you'll see is this goes down to 16 pixels. Now, these ones don't because we're actually using font size rem. So this is 3 times 16, so 48. And what we might want to do is make this change dependent on the width of the browser and maybe the height of the browser as well. Now, what we can do here is use a different unit called a Vmax or a Vmin. V just stands for the viewport, what we can see in here and how tall it is. Now, I kind of want to do this based on maybe the width and the height, but which one's wider? So here, what I'm going to do is add to my 16, the minimum, something like 1 Vmax. Basically, look at the width and the height, pick which one is the biggest, and then do 1% of this. If I save this now and refresh, you'll see this now does change depending on the size and the width of my browser. It's kind of a lot more fluid and a lot nicer as well. So if I'm going kind of small, it still kind of fits really nicely. We can still use breakpoints to basically override this when we go really small, for instance. Maybe I want to kind of temper that down. Maybe not 1%, but something like 0.5 kind of works pretty well. So if I save it now, what we'll see is this looking a lot neater. And this looks pretty good. We've basically added a few lines of CSS to improve our web typography in a very, very quick way. If you like that video, please let me know by just liking this video. It lets me know what topics to work on in the future for future videos. But if you have any other suggestions of videos that I should cover, please let me know in the comments as well.